We've had this particular Ram Rebel now for almost 2 months. Starting to get up there in miles. Let's see, 4,000, it's hard to read. 4,610 miles. Figured it was about time to change the oil in this thing for its first change. Big old mess. A lot Chrysler. I swear they do this just so it's so much of an inconvenience that you are forced to take it to the dealer. Sway bar, the anti-sway bar, it's behind, it was under the drive shaft and behind the oil pan. It's interesting. It's up pretty high and out of the way, that's for sure. You can see the skid plate, back end of the front engine transmission skid plate. I would suggest putting some kind of sheet or piece of metal or something to deflect that oil down this way and put your oil catch pan further up if you want to avoid a mess, but again, it's not too bad if you have something on the floor. Well, it took me a while to find the oil filter in this thing. Look, we're at the front, underneath the front, looking towards the back. And it's right there on the passenger side of the oil pan. Not exactly the easiest spot. I mean, looking at it from the bottom. Can't even like. Okay. This is gonna be interesting. Darn tight, Chrysler. can't get it off by hand, it'll help to get one of these oil filter cap wrenches. They fit right in a quarter inch ratchet. So the only thing is it's pretty tight in there. We'll see if I can get these in there. Make sure I got the right size. Take it to you, the dealer, and charge an arm and a leg for an oil change, and then suggest all kinds of other stuff that I probably don't need. Three different oil filter wrenches. An adjustable one, I think we'll save that. Worst comes to worst. Try this one first, I think. Hopefully there's enough room. Still not turning. Adjustable strap wrench. I have a feeling this isn't gonna do. Okay. How does this work? You're the hardest to open. Better work. Not always a clean job. Look at that. Things all.
Well, here's the oil filter for the Ram Rebel. And this is the oil filter for my 2004 Jeep Wrangler Rubicon. Funny, this is a smaller filter than this one. This is for the 4.0 straight six. This is for the 5.7 liter Hemi. So, go figure.
Be sure and put a little bit of oil around the gasket. So it doesn't get stuck there next time. Not that it did this time, but it's a good idea to keep it from getting stuck.
Alright, now that we've made it through all that, we're at the easiest part, which is just to fill the oil reservoir. In this case, I'm using Mobil 1 synthetic 5W20 as recommended by the manufacturer. I believe this takes 7 quarts. Mobil 1 is just a brand I've used for many, many years. And it's never failed. Funnel does not want to fit. Voila! Just need to fire it up. Check for any leaks. Be good to go. And we can do now is reset the oil. Like that.